And they did have to stop selling it because of the extraordinary amount of cocaine that was in it. What? I don't see what everyone's problem was.
No one was coughing anymore.
Yeah.
Having a discussion about this failed medicine. Not failed. Tactically withdrawn from the market.
I told you, so I don't have any more bottles.
Come on. You've got to help me here. I really need this stuff.
I was made to destroy them. By the authorities, old man.
You must have squirreled some away, I know you, Edvard.
I dumped quite a lot of it into the pond in the park, probably.
Right, well, I'll see you there. Okay. You lick clocks or something.
Pretty sure the only way to reduce a wanted level is for someone to go to prison.
Right. Not going to... Well, but does it have to be part of the crew? Because...
You sent someone else to prison.
Yeah. What I was thinking was perhaps I could persuade one of my more gullible school friends
to go to prison for it.
No, just to perform an extremely big crime and claim to be the mastermind of the hobby horses. And
this is such a good idea.
I can just pay him off later on, probably.
Yes, that's a great idea. Let's do that.
Rather on top of his business, isn't he? I'm starting to admire the guy, actually.
I angrily throw my whiskey tumbler into the fire.
It goes, now you're wasting whiskey! What's wrong with you, man?
Yes, quite possibly. I am...
A laser sight appears on the man's forehead.
Is an extending hand about to swing from across
the... I'm about to cock the extending hand. Boxing glove.
I was looking for Mr. Edvard, but I see that he clearly is at home. This looks like one of his inventions. I've
Edvard,
out.
Some friends of yours have just arrived. Do you want to take care of this?
And I drop a smoke bomb. And I cover myself in books.
I rarely answer the door, I don't realise that you actually have to shut it as well when people come in.
Roth, you remember Edvard from as the person you blow darted unconscious in.
Oh yeah.
Astor HQ. I know one of these is you, Edvard. But I don't know which one. I'll just start kicking them until I find it. And he walks up to a pile of books and just starts kicking the books. He's wrecking the books.
Hey! Oh, I struggle out of the pile of books. Stop kicking my books! What is it you want, Roth?
Found you
scoundrel. You want another blow dart, do you? I say, screwing together my blow dart apparatus.
It's funny you mentioned my employer. He would like a word.
Yes, I imagine he probably would. What does he want? To steal more of my inventions?
No.
Well, guess what?
He merely wants to meet with you in a public location.
You know, I've rather been looking forward to meeting Astor, actually. So whereabouts can we meet?
Come along. Just by the office. Not in the office, just nearby.
Barney, I don't want to go and meet him. He's my arch nemesis.
Follow me, Barnaby. Edvard, you can come if you want.
I wear his picture in this locket around my neck as proof of my hatred for him.
Well, perhaps you can leave with a lock of his hair or something. Come on.
I don't want a lock of his hair. I want him to stop stealing my inventions and die in shame.
Well...
And be buried in a pauper's grave. Is that so much to us?
Broken and dented, but unmistakable hand of the wonderful mechanical man.
My WLM! What have you done to him, you swine? I say, lunging at the hand.
I'm afraid.
My valises!
Your valises will be releases upon your exit,
says one of them who clearly fancied himself a comedian and didn't want to go into this line of work at all.
Spit it out, man. Why have you dragged us all the way down here? To steal my ideas? To steal the coat off my back, is it? You want the coat off? Fine! Maybe I'll give you the coat off my back, you... weasel, idiot, I say, struggling out of my coat.
Are you really giving him your coat?
This is how he operates, Barnaby. You wouldn't know.
I know a lot about losing coats.
Deal with that's honourable folk in your daily life. Well, and I throw it in his face.
Edvard, how have you been?
I think he's speaking to you, Edvard.
I thought we'd be fighting by now. What do you mean, have I been? Been Edvard, consumed with rage over your shenanigans.
I know that you are one of the hobby horses. Crime. Theft.
Is that what we settled on, Barnaby?
I think
doesn't this sound as cool when he says it?
Yeah.
It doesn't sound as cool when your hated rival says it to you.
Yeah.
Have that broken apart and analysed.
Have you broken apart and analysed?
God, you make it very hard for me to switch back into not smiling.
Sorry. Astor is good.
I think he is. I agree.
You raise your eyebrows after you tell a lie.
He's always one step ahead.
So your eyebrows didn't move then. That's
what does this mean, eh? Can't read the unreadable.
He's an enigma.
Yeah.
Edvard, please pay attention. He slams his hands on the table. A building that contains God knows how many other secrets.
Yes, discovered a few of them last time I was there, Astor, in fact.
What do you mean?
Well.
Quick, raise your eyebrows.
a simple lie. Fine. And falls away from you. And is completely sunk into the Volis River.
Hooray!
Bravo, bravo, Edvard. I mean, you've really excelled yourself this time. Certainly finally. Better than a boxing glove on an extending stick.
I can't believe the wishing well finally came through. That was a real last stitch effort there.
I will not, sir, stand idly by and see you destroy the world.
Destroy? Is that really our plan? I stop
I've
listening
said my piece.
Every time we start planning. I just zone out.
Barnaby, it's not the plan.
Do we? Okay, right. Are you sure?
Yes, we're to save the world. The opposite plan.
Astor is standing up. He's like putting his coat on while you have this little conversation between you. At that, Edvard, at you saying we're trying to save the world, he sort of shoots you both a look to try and see if you're serious or not. And he shakes his head. He says, "We're leaving." Gives a clap and the whole retinue sort of swarms around him. And they move away and are gone.
Edvard, I'm getting a bit of a cough.
Okay.
Any of your mixture available?
No. I told you. If you want it, you're going to have to go and drink the water out of the pond in the park.
Fine.
It's where it all is.
I'm so relieved to see that all of you are safe.
I screw together my blowpipe and I fire a paralyzing dart.
Yeah, okay. Yep. Looks down at the floor. Looks up at you, Edvard.
Must have been overcome by all these fumes. Probably not safe to be around here anymore, is it? Well, I suppose we'll be leaving.
Astor steps down and walks over to you, Edvard, and puts a hand on your shoulder and says, Edvard.
Flashback. <Yes. laughs> I coat my shoulder in a paralysing contact. Just in case anyone tried to patronisingly touch me on the shoulder today. He's been a real bugbear of mine lately.
Astor takes his hand away and looks at his leather glove and sees that it's covered in a fine white powder and is slightly sort of sizzling.
I'm going to assume that that's the case, and were I concentrating on what the gang's objective is, I'm sure I would agree with you.
Well, Barnaby, let me say this. He's stolen every idea I've ever had, so there's probably a bottle of my famous cocaine.
Well, why didn't you say
well.
So earlier?
That safe
let's,
as well.
Let's get
so,
that safe. Let's get that yeah. safe. I don't know why we're hanging around. Kwong, come up with an idea, quick.
Wonderful
or we
mechanical
could go...
merman.
Yeah, wonderful mechanical merman.
Or we could go for
the
a very
submersible mechanical man.
We could go for a very much manned operation and just pay a large number of poor people to keep diving in until one of them comes back with it.
Yeah, but then I mean, a lot of them would die though.
It's like four great ideas. Mm.
Yeah. Well, surely you have expertise in some area of something, Barnaby, then you can add to this?
No, it all sounds like robots and diving bells, which is really more your sort of field. I want to feel safe in my own city, you know, as a very, very privileged person.
My duty is to protect the people in this room, and to a much lesser extent, the people outside of this room. Do you remember the action man that swims and its arms just go like...
Yeah. exactly so.
Yeah. It's like that.
I'm going to propose something, and I don't want you to get angry, because I know you occasionally fly into a fit of pique when I mention his name, but...
Oh, right.
I do wonder whether it might behoove us to perhaps paint Amadeus Astor's logo on the diving bell, and perhaps also the wonderful mechanical frogman. Just to perhaps, you know, if some idle passerby spots the diving bell being lowered into the river, they'll assume it's Astor going to retrieve some of his belongings. You know, if you could see it within yourself to control the bile rising in your throat and perhaps...
To display the logo of that gadabout, that yes, popinjay.
But just on this one occasion.
That perhaps. Absolute zounderkite.
Now, I did say, please don't get angry with me, Edvard, because it's just...
You're the one who brought up that scobalotcher!
No, I think you've got it a bit wrong. It's more curly at the edges.
Yeah, also I've drawn a bum on it.
Not that
from
curly.
A distance, it'll look the same.
Okay, No, you're right.
But if you look close, there is an unmistakable bum.
Yeah. I say, do you want to come along on the mission, old boy? You sound like you'd be good company.
I would love to, and my name is... Billy Bell.
All right. Barnaby, Billy's coming along. Oh, Billy Bell.
Wonderful. Does he smell bad? He looks like he smells bad.
He smells strongly of fish. Yeah. But Edvard has formed a strong bond with
just what
Billy.
You need in a confined space.
Billy Bell may very well be my best friend.
Whoa! 2 6s and a 5.
Hey!
Amazing. So presumably the safe leaps out of the water. The safe leaps out. Hands.
And the door swings open. The contents fall into your waiting hands.
Yeah.
Excellent.
It's worth
okay.
It
couldn't have gone better.
Here's, right, here's
back to
where
the,
we're at.
Back to the club for a whiskey, old man. All right.
Leap into action and pour myself a pina colada.
Well, I'm going down there now. It's going to be very dangerous.
Ah, into the murky deep. Be ye sure, Mr. Edvard.
Yes, the briny deep. It may claim me.
But you'll remember what I told you about eels. He does a salute with his hook hand.
Hurts himself quite badly.
Cuts his eye off.
Pointing inwards.
All right. Whoever can cut their hand off quickest is the winner. But
river.
It's really a metaphor for his company and fortunes. But once what stood so proud, Barnaby, you're not listening. The once what stood so proud now right, lies like, at the bottom of the river, covered in sludge and eels.
Standing proud, got it.
Soon, so will, no, you, that's not the... One, what once stood so proud, Barnaby, now lies at the river, covered in eels. Mm. Soon, so will Astor himself also be the same.
Astor lies, yeah, got it, the usual, yeah.
We do need to move a few clicks south-west.
A few clicks. Oh,
no, a kilometre.
No, okay, not clicks.
Oh, crikey, I'll rig the sail. Don't you worry, Mr. Edvard.
You mostly hold your friends eels. Close because you don't know when an eel will suddenly leap out of the ocean.
Did you say eel? Did you see an eel?
No, there's no
there,
eel. There. I see no eels currently. Mr. Yeah, Fortescue, we really must get you back to your treatments. The pressure in your head,
know,
it could cause your head to explode if we don't relieve it.
Terrible, terrible consequences for, you know, things like police funding.
please enjoy your time at the bottom of the river at our crime scene. Thank you, bye. Yeah, cool. One stress for the harpoon right. Gun. That feels fair. Yeah.
That's
in
why
fact,
we bought
I'm
the
gonna
old...
start a clock.
Oh no.
That counts down to
eels
strike.
Exclamation
eel
mark.
Frenzy.
Eels exclamation mark. Yeah.
Okay.
Master, what is this feeling I feel?
It's the feeling of excitement for getting on a job, I say, and I kick him into the hole.
Do they always sound in pain?
I don't know why it keeps happening. I don't program that. Despite what he might tell you, I have not programmed him to feel pain. So.
Yeah, sure.
Yes, there are eels, but bring us up slowly.
He overhears.
That's why we need to be pulled up with a haste, Mr. Bell.
I'll winch you immediately, sir.
You know how he feels about eels, Barnaby. You can't panic the man.
Yes, but I also feel bad about the bends, which he was also talking about.
Yeah.
It's one of the few words I caught. A bit about your blood exploding.
To your...
My coat!
Your torso. Your coat
bloody
is ruined,
hell. Bloody hell. Bloody hell.